folks, and welcome to another video tutorial by WPBasics.org. In today's tutorial, we will be adding a video background to the Infinity Pro theme by Genesis. The Infinity Pro theme is already a beautiful theme, but adding a video background just gives it a little extra something. We will transform the theme from this to this. I think that looks pretty good. Well, enough of the introduction. I will now go into the background and rip out all the code and show you how to add a video background in a few easy steps. So the first thing that we need to do is to download a plugin. Click on the plugins link on your dashboard and then click on Add New. The plugin you are looking for is called Video Background by Blake Wilson. Go ahead and download and then activate the plugin. Next, click on the Getting Started link that is below the title Video Background. A new page will appear, and on that page is a shortcode. Copy the shortcode as you will need it in a little bit. Now open your favorite text editor. Once the text editor is open, open the frontpage.php file. Go to the end of line 111 and hit enter a couple of times to give yourself a little room to work. Now type the following: echo space do underscore shortcode, and then open and close brackets and end that with a semicolon. Now go ahead and add a pair of single quotation marks inside the brackets and paste your short code so that your code looks something like this. Save your code. Now I will assume that you already uploaded a video loop to your media library. If you did not, go ahead and do that now. When you are done uploading your video, go to your media library and click on the video that you want to use. Near the top right-hand corner, you will see a little word called URL. Copy the URL. Go back to your text editor and replace the pound symbol immediately after MP4 with the URL you copied as follows. Now go ahead and save your code. Now we need to specify which container we want the video to appear in. Use Google Chrome if you want to follow along with the rest of the tutorial. Navigate to your site and right-click anywhere on the home page and select Inspect. Now you will notice that as you scroll around that different sections get highlighted. If we scroll over front-page-1, we see that the whole front page is highlighted. So this is the container we want. Now go ahead and go back to your text editor and replace body with .front-page-1. Go ahead and save your code. Now go ahead and go back to your browser and refresh the screen. Your video should now appear. However, we can still see the default image in the background if I refresh like so. Let's get rid of the image. Now go back to your dashboard and click on Appearance and then on Customize. Now you can select Front Page Background Images. The first section is called Featured Section 1 Image. Go ahead and click on Remove to get rid of the image and then click on Save. You can now see that the image is gone by refreshing the screen like so. So the video background now works on large screens, but on small screens, it does not cover the entire screen. We can see that here. If you are okay with this, you can leave it as is. If you want it to cover the entire screen, just add the following code to the bottom of your styles.css file. You would add .vidbg-container space video, open and close curly brackets, and inside there you would write max width none, and be sure to add exclamation mark important, and end that code with a semicolon. Once you do that and save it, you can go back and refresh it and see that the video now covers the entire screen of the mobile device. The final tweak that I like to add is overlay. You can see that the video is pretty bright and that the words are a little hard to read. We can add an overlay by simply going to our text editor and changing overlay equals open close bracket quotations false to overlay equals open close quotations true. Let's have a look what that did. You can adjust the color of the overlay in the overlay underscore color equals open close quotations 000 section, and the opacity is controlled by overlay underscore alpha equals open close quotations 0.3. The higher the number, the darker the color. Now, let's go ahead and change the color of the overlay just to for display purposes. There you have it. Let's save it and have a look. Looks pretty good, I think. Well, folks, I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, don't forget to subscribe and like this channel. Thank you, and see you later. Bye-bye.